Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we will learn about how to find out the initial basic feasible solution for a given transportation problem using northwest corner method. Now we will see what are the steps to follow to find out the initial basic feasible solution for a given transportation problem by using northwest corner method. So here, whatever transportation problem is given to you, that is in the form of matrix, that is, it is a combination of rows and columns. Okay, so from that matrix, first step is what? We have to select the northwest corner. Now after selecting the northwest corner, we have to allocate maximum possible units to that cell depending upon the demand and supply numbers. After this, third step is what? We have to subtract this number from the corresponding demand and supply. Fourth step is what? After subtracting the number from the respective demand and supply, we have to delete that particular row or column fulfilling supply or demand condition. Then we have to repeat the above procedure. Now we will see how to solve the actual problem of the transportation by using the northwest corner rule method. Okay, now this is the problem. Now in this, different markets are given to you and warehouses are given to you. So here markets are M1, M2, M3 and warehouses are W1, W2, W3, and with respect to that there is a supply and there is a demand. Okay, to start with the solution, we have to follow the first step, that is what? We have to select the northwest corner. So here northwest corner is what? The cell having the address W1 M1, which I shown you in the red color. So after selecting the northwest corner, that is W1 M1 cell, we have to check for the supply number and demand number. So if you see, for the selected cell, that is selected northwest corner, supply value is how much? 61, and for the same cell, demand value is 52. So second step is what? We have to allocate the maximum possible units to the selected cell, right? So here supply is of 61 and demand means requirement is of 52. So here in the supply we are with the 61 units, so we have to allocate the maximum possible unit, that is the required unit, that is we have to allocate 52 units to the cell W1 M1. Okay, now here we have to allocate the maximum possible units to the cell W1 M1. After allocating 52 units to the selected northwest corner, we have to subtract that respective number from the supply and demand. So initially supply was of 61 units, so from 61 we are going to allocate 52 to the cell, right? So 61 minus 52 means what? Now in the supply 9 units are remaining, and if you see in the demand column, demand is of 52 units, right? So we are going to assign the 52 units to that cell. So here there is a fulfillment of the demand, so we have to write down 52/0, means what? Ki now there is a no demand from that column. Okay, as there is a fulfillment of the demand, means in the demand you will get that 0, so we have to cross out that column. Okay, now we have to repeat the same procedure. Okay, so again we have to select the next northwest corner. So here our new northwest corner is the cell having address W1 M2, which I have shown you in the green color. Now for the selected northwest corner, check the supply values and demand values. Okay, so whatever units are available in the supply means what? We are with the that much number of units. Okay, so from that we have to allocate the maximum units to the selected cell. So here available units are how many? 9, and demand or requirement is of how many units? 68. So here to the selected cell we can allocate maximum units, that is 9. As we have allocated 9 units to the selected northwest corner, so now we have to subtract that number from the respective supply and demand. So here if you subtract 9 minus 9, then what we will get? 0. So here supply is 0 and requirement, that is demand, is of 68. So out of 68 we are going to assign maximum units, that is 9. So here demand is of how many? 68 minus 9, that you will get as a 59. So we have to write down that number as what? 68/59. Okay. So after allocating 9 units to the selected cell, now there is a fulfillment of the supply. That is, in the supply now 0 units are available. So we have to cross out that first row. Now again we have to repeat the procedure. That is, we have to select the next new northwest corner. So here our next new northwest corner is a cell having address W2M2, that is the cell having value 13, okay, which I have shown you in the blue color. Now for that cell, the supply values are 49 and demand values are 59. So whatever possible units are available, we have to allocate that maximum possible units to the selected cell. Okay. So here available units are how many? 49. Requirement is of how many? 59 units. So we have to allocate 49 to the selected cell. So after allocating 49 to the selected cell, now if you see the supply value, that is become 0. So 49/0. Why? Because we have allocated maximum units to the selected cell. Now we have to subtract that respective allocated number from the requirement, that is from the demand. So 59 minus 49, so here requirement is of 10 units is remaining. Now if you observe the second row, there is a fulfillment of the supply values, right? So we have to cross out that second row. Now again we have to repeat the same procedure. That is, we have to select the next northwest corner. So here next northwest corner is the cell having address W3M2, that is the cell having value 17. Now for that cell, which I have shown you in the yellow color, for that cell check the supply values and the demand values. Now supply value is of 90 units and demand is of 10 units. So we have to allocate maximum possible units to the selected northwest corner. Okay. So here we have to allocate the 10 units. Why? Because requirement is of how many units? 10 units. So out of 90, we have to allocate 10 units to the selected cell. So after allocating 10 units to the selected cell, if you see in the M2 column, there is a fulfillment of the demand, right? That is, demand value is 0. As there is a fulfillment of the demand value, that is in the column M2, we have to cross out the column M2. Now we have to select the next northwest corner. So here our next northwest corner is the cell having address W3M3, which I have shown you in the purple color, right? So that is the new northwest corner. Now for that, supply value is how much? 80 units, and for the same, demand value is of 80 units. Okay, so available units are 80 and requirement is also of 80. So we have to allocate the 80 units to the selected cell. So as we are going to allocate 80 units to the selected cell, so supply values become 0 and demand values also 0. Means what? Okay, here if you see all the supply values and all the demand values, at the end there is a 0, means our problem stops here. Now our next step is what? Okay, we have to calculate the transportation cost. Okay. Now to calculate the transportation cost, we have to select the allocated cells only, which I have shown you in the color, right? So here first cell is having the red color, that is what? 26 into 52, plus next cell is 23 into 9, plus 13 into 49, plus 17 into 10, plus 29 into 80. So answer is what? Rupees 4686, that is 4686. So this is the transportation cost for the given transportation problem. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you like my videos, then please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon.